So let's start with our first project, which is Twitter scraping to get trending hashtags once again, and let's see what are these steps we are going to follow to do this project. So the first step is to open the browser, of course. Second one will be to go into Twitter, then explore, and then to trending. Next one will be to gathering the hashtags, and after that we'll be going to the I'll be doing. I'll be simply opening this particular URL with my program. Actually, so let's just do this. So to do this, what I need to use this browser.get, and here I just need to give the URL that I want to open. So I'm just copying that URL from there and pasting it over here. So let me just try to run this thing. So it is taking a while to open this. That means I'll have to apply. So here, to find any element in any page, what we need to do, you need to find how that particular element is stored in the source code of that particular page. For that, I'll have to inspect this page. Okay, so these are the tags over here. So the first one is Arels Shreya, the second one is Patanjali IPL. So let me just hover over this thing. So if I click on this, so this is a span element with this particular class name. Inside this, we are having this text which is specifying the hashtag over there. If I move to any other hashtag also, so this is again one span element, and this one, let's look at the third hashtag. So this is again a span element. That means all the hashtags are stored as span elements. So I'll write browser dot fine. Let me copy the function from there only. So yeah. So I've got this function. I'll paste it over here. Find element by tag name. And here, which element I'm interested in? I'm interested in this span. Okay. So let's store this in this with this particular name. Out of all these things, I just want to consider those things which are starting with a hashtag, right? For that, I can use this function a dot start with, and then here the thing that I want to check for, right? So I'll have to put this inside a if statement, so that for only those text which is starting with hashtag, only for those tags I want to print this A. Okay. Now if I run this, okay. So here the next step is to go to the tweets. That means what happens here, whenever you click on any hashtag, let me just click on this one. Whenever this happens, then we are taking to the page where they have multiple hashtag, multiple tweets which are having this particular hashtag, right? So to get to those tweets, I need to open this particular. So what will be happening for each of these elements, these URL will be created. Now what I want to do, I want to have a list, another list with these URLs. So yeah, this is done now. Let me run this one last time. So let's wait for it to work. So this page is appearing over here. Once we are at this page, then it will take a couple of minutes to run the program because it is a bit time taking. Okay, so this is done. So it is showing me the data is stored at C user Shweta Twitter hashtags dot CSV tool. Let me just go to my location and see whether this is stored or not. Yeah. Here I just look for Twitter. Yeah, so I have this particular CSV file stored there. So let me just open this. Okay, so here we have the first column as hashtag, the second column as HR.